Hello, you all. Welcome back to Let's Deal With It. Praise the Lord. It is so wonderful to be back on here. I truly do pray for those who are blinded by the God of this world, HaSatan. When I say that, I'm in referencing to the YouTube folks and Facebook. Wow, they know not what they're doing, which some of them do, but I mean to the degree of burning in hell, they don't know. So I just pray you all that a lot of people's eyes would be open before it's too late, because we are absolutely on the dawn of the change of a dispensation. Grace is wrapping up and the wrath of Yahweh is coming on in. And it's unreal how Christians have no clue. They have no clue. I mean, that's something else. But I'm learning not to be too stunned and too surprised, because that's what being religious will get you. To me, you are more blind than those who don't even know the way, the truth, and eternal life, which is Jesus Christ. I'm not stunned anymore, because I'm gaining understanding how someone could be so blinded and in such darkness and so self-deluded. Is because they're religious. They don't have a relationship with the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I'm telling you all, I never like speaking in absolutes, but 9 times out of 10, the religious don't read their Bible. The religious don't pray. And if they do, they read it to be what's called ever learning, but come on, Holy Spirit, ever learning, but never coming to the truth. And if they do pray, they pray in a mist, because prayer will change the soul, the heart, and the mind. Life, praying to the Lord will change your life. So when you is in the company of a heap of people who do not have the love of Jesus Christ, they is cold, the Bible say. In Matthew, it say the love of many has waxed cold. So that tell me 2 things. Either they started out right. Paul said, you did start out right. Either Paul or Peter, who did hinder you? So there are many people who started out with the Lord and then they don't went to the left. And they become those, when the Bible say, carnal minded and lukewarm. Yes. And then you have those who was never saved. They're just tares and wolves and sheep and wolf's clothing. They don't know the Lord. They don't know him at all, and he don't know them. And he fixing to tell them, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. I never knew you. Them going to be the ones also when Jesus said, why call me Lord and do not what I say? Them is the once saved, always saved. These is all of these communities who are enemies of God and they don't even know it. You got people, I done said this several times and I'm going to keep saying it, hoping prayerfully that these types of self-deluded individuals who are religious will get the fear of the Lord, because the Bible says, fear the Lord and depart from sin and iniquity. We is going to wade in the water right here. We ought to have such a fear of the Almighty Holy Yahweh that we depart from sin and iniquity and go about doing good for the glory of his holy name. Did you hear that? And we ought to be working out the salvation of our souls. You know, that's the scripture, with fear and trembling before the Lord. So I don't know where lukewarm can fall into that carnalness and once saved, always saved. We is called children of light and not darkness. So you all keep playing church instead of being a church. You all are in for the rudest awakening of regret ever in your life. It's not going to die down. You ain't going to be able to shake it off with a new weave, with new fingernails, a new man, a better car, a bigger house. And you bishops and pastors and preachers and teachers and evangelists, help me, Holy Spirit. I thought Benny Hinn truly repented. That man is a bit more experienced godly sorrow and repentance than a man on the moon, which that never happened. But anyway, you all, you leaders in the brick and mortar, it's going to be hell to pay for most of you. I said, hell's fire is going to be you all's eternal home. Especially you all who are in the bed with the government, the 501c3. That is your God, Mammon. The glamorous life that you so puss and lust after, you got it. But guess what you're going to pay for eternity? Hell's fire. You have misled and scattered so many of the Lord's sheep. It's unreal. But payday is coming for everybody. I say everybody is here. And you leaders who have counseled the children of the Lord to take this right here, if I was you all, I would publicly repent and I would hurry up and denounce and get rid of that 501c3. I want you to know you're in covenant with the enemy. Them churches, them brick and mortars, they do not belong to the living Yahweh of Israel and his holy son, Yeshua HaMashiach. Furthermore, his Holy Spirit is not in any of those brick and mortar buildings. I said not one. Okay, so saints, as you can see, I'm coming out blazing with two fists, coming out, because we is tick tock, the demons ain't gonna stop. Oh no, they getting ready to have a, ooh wee. You ought to go look at several movies and music. Yep, you right. Most of the music is singing about Lucy, who is Satan. Nearly all the movies it's called predictive programming. That's what it is. And it's showing you what's coming and what done came in the past, the present, and the soon coming future. You go on and look at Contagion and I Am Legend, Men in Black, Independence Day, Below Zero. I believe that's the name of that movie. It's about a big train and all the people is living on the train and they got the high society people in the front of the plane, the elite. Oh my. And they got the peasants and the dumb sheeplies living in the back of the train. And you guys go see that movie. I believe it's called Below Zero. Oh my goodness, it came to me. I'm gonna have to look that movie up. So anyway, you all, I don't have time to patty cake with nobody. We're not finna jump hopscotch, jump double dutch. We are not gonna play jacks. This is your soul at stake. And if you all knew what they already got in plan, and it's gonna come to pass for them, because the Lord is gonna allow them to bring this to pass. And if he gonna let man's word come to pass, what you think his holy word is? He said, everything that I said, I'm gonna bring it to pass, including this catching up and this catching away, this harpazo, the rapture, the harvest, whatever you wanna call it. I'm gonna call it a going home of all going homes. Yes, it's about to take place. And I know we got a lot of naysayers and gainsayers out there laughing at folks like me and others like me, but it's okay, because you won't be laughing last. No, you finna be what the Bible says, man's hearts will fail them for the things they see coming upon the earth. And it's not just gonna be you know what I'm saying, B to the O to the M to the B. Oh, it's not going to be just that. No, no, that's scary enough. But when you see these dark entities, 10 and 15 and 20 feet tall, they coming. Oh, I know y'all don't believe it. And when the abyss open up, y'all think it's not going to happen. But see, the ones that don't think it's going, the ones that think it's not going to happen, you'll be the most devastated. You all, it's going to make you more than poop and pee on yourself. Yes. Yeah, it is. And see, this is why I have had the courage. And the, you know, the Bible talks about the cowardly, the liars and all abominables. They're going to have their place in the lake of fire. The fearful, we shouldn't be fearing nobody but the Holy Almighty Yahweh. Let me tell you all something. You who have taken this, you acting like you're good, but you're not good. You far from good. And furthermore, the Bible said there is none good but the Lord. You all who took this, hurry up and seek the Lord's forgiveness and cleansing and purging and washing. Because when the switch flip, when they flip that switch, Z to the O, to the O, to the M, to the I, to the E, or you can spell it Z to the O, to the O, to the M, to the Y. Any way you want to spell it, that's what you all are getting ready to do. And you're getting ready to be alive. I'm talking about put all the boogeyman demonic pictures together. It's still not going to touch what y'all getting ready to do to other people. And especially those who play with the Lord. You guys, if you think Freddy Krueger and Michael Myers was something, and it's going to be the purge in the birdcage. It's going to be worse than that, though. It is. But that's a good start to think about them movies, how it's going to be. Yeah, it's pretty good. But it ain't going to compare nor touch to what it's going to really be. So you keep on acting like you don't have nothing to repent of. You go right ahead. Because see, here's the danger of that. This is the time. This is the moment. The last moments in time to repent of this diabolical abomination standing in the place where it ought not be. That's not no temple in Israel. That's you who is supposed to be the temple of the Almighty Yahweh. Yahweh's name, Yah, is written in our DNA. D to the N to the A. Okay, yes. And this right here, oh, it done spliced it right on out. Uh-huh. Yeah. So if I were you all, I would humble myself under the mighty hand of the Almighty Yahweh. And I'd do like David did. When David, he sinned royally. And he admitted it. He bitterly sought the forgiveness of the Almighty Yahweh. And he begged the Lord, don't take your spirit away from me. Because I want you to know, this right here can house the Holy Ghost. I said, no, Jesus, it can't. So you all can stand in an arrogance and a proud look if you want to. You will not be standing for long. And not only that, you will open your eyes in hell's fire. And take my time, because I already know the enemy is, if y'all only knew. But you know what? I'd rather him be mad with me and the Almighty Holy Yahweh angry with me. I'm not no coward in the spirit. Understand? I'm going to tell y'all just what he gave me to tell you. I'm not going to stand before a Holy Almighty Yahweh and hear him say, why did you compromise my word? Why did you not tell them exactly what I said? I ain't going to have to worry about that. Now, on the other hand, you New Age pastors, I'm going to even start calling you all that, because that's what doctrines of demons are, New Age religions. That's what y'all teaching folks. You got nothing in there in them brick and mortars but cults, occults. That's all y'all got. You all are not brick and mortars where the spirit of the Lord is welcome, nor where he can stay. You is all Ichabods. which means the glory of the Lord has lifted. That's what you all are. And you carnal, lukewarm Christians that flock to these type of leaders, preachers, bishops, teachers, self-appointed apostles, you all are the itch and ear community. That's what you carnal, lukewarm, once saved, always saved folks are. You make sure you go and find leaders that's going to tell you what you want to hear, which is live your best life now. You good to do that. And I'm being facetious when I say you good to do it, because this is the best it's going to get for y'all. They finna shut down the whole A to the M to the E to the R to the I to the CA. She getting ready to fall in 1 hour. You know, like Revelation says something y'all don't never read. The smoke of her is going to go up. This month, yeah, it's finna happen. She got to fail. She got to utterly be destroyed. You understand? America, America, God shed his grace on thee. No more, America, no more. Okay? This is a cesspool of all kind of unclean birds, frogs, lasciviousness, perversion, and unclean, I'm talking abomination spirits, abominable. Anytime they gonna make a song talking about now we're coming for your children, they gonna regret every word, every letter they sung in that song. And they're going to have eternity to live it out. And that means to never stop. Eternity is forever. Okay? Yes. That's when we should have known it was over. Never mind, and I don't mean that facetiously, with the rumors of wars and earthquakes, divers earthquakes, and when them people had the goals and the wherewithal to make a song to say we are going to convert your children, we should have knew it was over then. Y'all should have known. When folks started going up in churches with G-U-N-S's and killing folks, you should have woke up then, church. You should have woke up then. But I'm going to tell you why a whole bunch of y'all is sleeping with a bottle in your mouth. It's your pastors. They got into bed with Hasatan, Satan, over the love of money. And you mean to tell me you pastors and preachers and teachers never read where it says the love of money is the root of all evil? And all means all. So if I was you self-appointed apostles, bishops, which is nothing but a true man of servant and man of the Lord, y'all done made that grandiose. Pastors and preachers and teachers and evangelists, Benny Hinn, you should be ashamed of yourself. Joyce Myers, Joel Osteen, T.D. Jakes, Jamal Bryant, Todd Mike, Michael Todd, whatever y'all names is, you all think you big enough and bad enough for hell's flames, for fire, forever? You know y'all is turned over to a reprobated mind. You know, I was thinking, Lord, can't they see? Perhaps they are now turned over to a reprobated mind. And do you know that means there's no returning from there? There's no coming back. If the Lord Almighty, the Holy One of Israel, have turned you over to a reprobated mind? Let's think about that. And here you got folks attending church every Sunday. Can't wait to get up there and sing. No anointing, not a drop. I said, not a drop. No conviction, not a bit of fear of the Most High Yahweh. I just heard Brother Wally say they get up there in them choirs and they sing, and they get right back to fornicating and sinning Monday. I say Sunday night, bless the Lord. He just gave me that. You all are not saved. And I know you all are watching the videos. The Lord had me to know it because I can recall going to a church. I got so many nasty looks and daggers in me. It was unreal. But I was not worried about it because I'm not the Lord and neither are you and nobody else. The Lord is the Lord. And he know you guys done heard the truth. Now, what you should do is have the humility that the Lord told us all to have and repent and ask for the Lord's forgiveness and get right. Get rid of your little boyfriends that don't want to marry you. Grown men, 30, 40, 50, 60 years old, shacking up with women, stupid, silly women. You all really know better. Because the Bible said that let the older women teach the younger, but you can't teach these young women nothing. Of course you can't, because you're not right. So you all keep playing with sin. Talking about you as a Christian. Up in them choirs and praise team, singing. I'm leave that alone because I'm not going to beat a dead horse. Nope, I'm not going to do that. Because you all know what you're doing. See, in my day, and those who are 60, 70, and 80, back in their day, there was more time ahead of us to get right. You young people ain't got that time. Let me say that again. When I was in my sin, there was more time ahead of me. Now, I didn't know that. None of us knew that. So we had time to be for God to wink at us for so long. But you all guys don't have that type of grace of time. No. We are now on the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ for his beloved bride, his beloved saints. Notice I didn't say Christians. Young people don't have the time we had. See, I'm being real with you because we was toe up too. We was just as raggedy and sinful and lustful and trifling as can be. I know I was. See that? So you all, if your man not gonna marry you, you need to put him out. If your woman don't wanna marry you brothers, you need to put him out. Cause you playing the drums, playing the piano, brothers. Brothers. You're handling the spiritual things of the Lord with dirty hands and an unclean heart. See, I'm over here, the almighty living Yahweh of Israel, the creator of heaven and earth, all the stars, the moon, the clouds, the fish in the seas, the honeybees, the flowers and the trees. I'm going to hear the most holy, holy Lord Yahweh. Say, the devil can be mad all he want. I don't care. I know I'm going through because of the gospel. Yes, I accept it now. I accept the hardship. I'm going to endure it as a good soldier in the army of the living almighty Yahweh. So, you all, I'm not going to hear from the Lord. Why didn't you? Nope. I'm going to hear him say, well done. I said, I'm going to hear him say, well done, my good and faithful servant. Ain't that something? Yes. See, you can't have this boldness and anointing fearing man. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. I said, no. You can't be this way being a people pleaser. You need to be a pleaser of the Lord. That's why the Bible says the fear of man brings a snare, but those who trust in the Lord will be secure. Okay, so you all, we gonna pray. Had to get it all out. Yes, indeedy. Yep, it's crunch time. A lot of people don't believe it. And thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, Holy Spirit, I love you. Thank you. Now, I am one that don't believe in saying at this day, at this time, I just don't believe any of us could pinpoint it to the exact day. I just don't believe that, nor the exact time. Now, Jesus said, if I come in the third or the fourth watch, ain't that something? Midnight. We don't know. But I can tell you what we can know when that day is approaching. And that day is approaching. We are so close to it, we can smell it and taste it, some of us. I said a few. The Bible said a few gonna find the path that leads to eternal life. A few. A few. Okay? So you folks playing with the Lord, your gig is up. It's time to stop playing pity pat. Time to stop going to these pastors and preachers' church. Brother Wally call them cupcake pastors and preachers. That's a good name. That is a very good name. Anyway, going over the revelations of Jesus Christ, you talking about being fast-tracked in the spirit, going over to that mighty anointed, I believe he got a double portion. And another brother, another servant, mightily anointed, Brother Anthony Williams. And now I know for a fact there's a few people that don't like that I still honor and respect the Spirit of God and Pastor Sandy, but I'm going to respect that man of God because he is. And by the way, none of us are perfect. Not one of us. He done said some things he should have not said against other brothers and sisters in Christ. Yeah, he done that. But what I'm going to do, just like I done prayed for Brother Anthony and pray for other brothers and sisters in Christ, that the Lord will show them where they're not right. Just like I hope people is praying for me. I'm not always right, but the difference is I believe with Brother Anthony and folks like myself, we haven't intentionally tried to be wrong. That's a difference. Now, Pastor Sandy, I have to call it what it is. He have called people weird. He have downplayed the gift of the Holy Spirit in Brother Patrick, Hourly Watch. If any young man that I know is anointed with them stars and the moon, after all, Jesus said the signs will be in the sun, moon, and the stars. Jesus said that. So see, Pastor Sandy is in error and he's wrong. He's not right. And I say, Lord, please correct him, because you are using your servant Patrick in a profound and powerful way. I mean, after all, what did the wise men follow? The Bethlehem star. You all hear me? So I'm not going to stop watching Pastor Sandy. Now, I did stop watching him for a while because I was highly offended and upset with the way he came after our brother Anthony Williams. I didn't like that. But I had to forgive Pastor Sandy, and I pray that Brother Anthony do the same and let the Lord deal with his servant. Amen? Yes. Yes. And I'm praying that Pastor Sandy repent, because Jesus said the signs of his coming will be in the sun, moon, and the stars. Now, see, that's how we can get, see, when you get to smelling yourself, we can all be guilty of that, everybody. And we all done did it in one way or another. I believe we all have been guilty of that. And we must say, Father, forgive me and help me to stay humble and give you all the glory, honor, and praise. Because I do recall Jesus saying, without me, you are nothing. And apart from me, you can do nothing. Now, that's what Jesus say. That's what the Lord say. Okay? Yeah. And then he said, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. So you all, let's pray. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. See what fasting will do for you. Pastor Jerry Tony. I know many folks don't like him. I know he has a serious problem thinking that God don't call his daughters to preach and teach his holy word. That's a lie. That's a lie. That's a lie. And I have prayed for him, but I did not stop watching Pastor Jerry Tony. No, I prayed for him. And then not only that, he don't believe that folks can repent of the Maxi, the Pokemon. He's wrong. So I prayed for him. We got to pray for one another, especially when pride begins to get in us. And now Marcus Rogers, I love that young man, but he done got a little cocky. He done got to the side a little bit, but we have to pray for him because that young man loved the Lord. Yes, he do. But now them folks like Joyce Myers and Joel Osteen and Creflo Dollar and the Copelands, I'm gonna leave that in God's hands. Yes. But those of us who have made mistakes, not willfully and on purpose, and let's say we have God in the flesh, amen. Pray for us. Pray. Amen. Amen. All right. Is that it, Holy Spirit, for now, Lord? Okay, so saints, we're going to pray, because when I tell you, get right, church, and let's go home. There are going to be some Christians that are going to become show enough sanctified saints in a quick time. Because, see, it don't matter what hour you come in. Jesus talked about the good man who he paid all the workers the same wages, and that is him. I wouldn't care if I made it in on the tail end. I made it in. Amen. And we should want folks to make it in. And I see a whole bunch of sisters in sin here, and it's just not here. It's all in the world. They really have self-deluded themselves. Study living and shacking up with a man, gossiping, full of jealousy and envy and hatred. I know a heap of them. And they go to church every Sunday. My thing is this. What good is it to go to church and you're not changing? That's why I know these are not the place, the brick and mortar where the Holy Spirit dwells and abides. Mm-mm. They're not even country clubs. I'm going to call them cults, a cults. That's what I'm going to call them. They is the synagogues of Satan, just like in the Bible with the Sadducees and the scribes and the Pharisees. That's all you guys are. And Jesus had his most difficult and challenging moments with the religious. Yeah, let's wait right there. Okay, let's go on. So yes, let's pray. So saints, I want you to know, Sister Susan, I've been lifting up your daughters, Hannah and Ariana, nearly every day. Amen, sister. And I've been lifting up all the beloved saints, adult children, who may be prodigal sons and daughters, who may you never raised them while they were in your care as a parent, because you didn't know the Lord. Yet and still, the Lord is able. Amen. And I just truly believe he was showing me how he will never go against people's wills to love him and serve him and love others. He won't do that. Thank you, Holy Spirit. A whole bunch of Christians going to be left behind because they have not the love of God. Don't worry about this. Well, you should. But a whole bunch of Christians ain't going to make it into Harpazo because they don't have the pure love of God through Jesus Christ shed abroad in their hearts. There is some of the most cold, hating, nasty, malicious folks calling themselves Christians up in the brick and mortar than I've ever seen in my life. Okay, so Lord help me here. I'm telling you, he's coming out blazing. Yep. So, beloved saints, the Lord showed me how he'll never make our adult children love him and choose him in this moment. But if we raise them, and even if we didn't, if we've been praying for them, fasting and collectively pressing in the spirit for their souls, our prayers will meet them in the very near future. Oh, yes. Don't worry. It is. I believe that with all my heart. Yes, I believe it. And you say, but how can you be so sure, Sister Marcia? Because the Lord says we're two or more touching and agreeing, asking anything in his name. He said it's going to be done. See that? And then he said, train up a child in the way they should go. And even if they depart, they're going to come back just like the prodigal son. So let's have confidence, trust, and faith and hope in the Almighty Living Yahweh and his precious Holy Son, the lover of our souls, and his powerful, all-powerful Holy Spirit to wake them up just in time. Or the fear of the Lord gonna get them. Once that tribute, they gonna know, dear God, my mama tried to tell me over and over and over and over, number four, that Jesus was coming. Lord Jesus, give me strength to be beheaded. Some, I hate to say it, it's the Lord's business. I hope it's not our children. But some folks going to be tortured, then beheaded. Yeah, you all, I'm telling you the truth. Because that's how vile Satan is and his Antichrist and his foot soldiers are. And a whole heap of human beings that are his children. But this is why I keep telling you all to fast. So you can fast about these things. Excuse me, you all. You can fast about these things. Yes. See that? If we ever ought to be fasting for our children, souls, is now. Amen? So, don't be overwhelmed with fear, because fear is not of the Lord, you all. You all got to go on over to Brother Wally's channel, Revelations of Jesus Christ. And his last message, Gripped by Fear, I am employing you. Go over to Revelations of Jesus Christ and look at his last video, Gripped by Fear. Please do it. So anyway, we are going to pray for our older children and for each other, okay? And don't forget, you all, fast at least once a week. If you can make it two, that would be very good. Amen. And anything outside of that, above, you really rocking in the spirit. And it's not that one day or 2 days is discounted. I'm just saying there's different levels of good and excellent. The Bible did say his good, acceptable, and perfect will. His acceptable, good, and perfect will. Amen. All right. You know, because folks, they going to scrutinize everything, the true beloved saints, but them Christians is on us. But guess what they're doing? They're biting and devouring the real beloved saints. They already in trouble. Every person who have left the nasty comment, unsubscribe, which is fine. I hope that you do. I do not care. No. But I'm just telling you all, you're going to answer for your biting and your devouring, for your mocking and your scoffing. Yes, we do reap what we sow. Okay. All right, you all, let's pray. Hallelujah. I feel my strength and help from the Holy Spirit. My Lord. Okay. So Heavenly Father, we come tonight thanking you, Lord, that we can come in by the blood of the Lamb. We can come in by the name of your Holy Son, and we're coming praying your word, because we know you answer your word. Hallelujah. And you promised us, Heavenly Father, we're two or more, and there's more than two of us. I don't know how many there are, but you do. And you said we're two or more touching and agreeing, asking anything. And that anything means things that you want. Things that would please you. And there is nothing more pleasing to the Almighty Yahweh, to you, Abba, to you, Jesus, than for souls to be won. It says in your word, heaven rejoices over one soul truly becoming saved. Yes, hallelujah. So, Lord, we ask that you would dispatch your angels, ministering angels, to arrest the minds, the souls, and the hearts and the spirits of our children. We ask, Heavenly Father, that every chain of bondage, of addiction, would be broken off of them in the mighty holy name of Jesus Christ. We plead the holy blood of Yeshua HaMashiach against every demon of homosexuality, bisexuality, crack cocaine, crystal meth, trank, fentanyl, heroin, flocka, every cigarettes, marijuana, every unclean spirit of drugs, alcohol. We come against these demons, unclean spirits, in the authority of Jesus's holy name, and we bind their operation against the souls and the spirits and the minds and the body of our children. You said whatever we bind on this earth, it will be bound in heaven. So we're doing what you say to do, Heavenly Father. That's why we know you're going to answer our prayer. Satan, the Lord Yahweh, rebuke you. Jesus Christ, rebuke you. You have no authority over our children. We have covered them with the word. We have plead the blood of Jesus over them. And we have asked, Heavenly Father, that your angels would go out and arrest them, convict them, Holy Spirit. Convict them of the sinful state that they are living in. Let them have no peace until they call on you, Jesus, and ask you to save them, to heal them, deliver them, and make them ready to meet you in the clouds. You can do it. I know you can, and I know you will. And if they choose, because it's all about our choice and what we will to do, either choose life or death, blessing of cursing, you told us to choose, amen, to choose life. So, Father, we are standing in the gap for them. We are sending prayers ahead of them in this tribulation. Yes, Father, we're doing that. And we thank you that your tenacity, your boldness and courage will come upon them, and they will be ready to die for the salvation that Jesus brought in his body. Yes. Yes, they will. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray and we ask this. And Heavenly Father, I want to pray for every beloved saint who is overwhelmed with fear, anxiety over their children, even over things that they're going through in this life. If you guys only knew what I was facing, if you can do it for me, and I have to constantly pull down every thought that tries to exalt itself above the word of God to take it captive. Do I do it perfectly every day? You all, I'm not going to lie, no. But the Holy Spirit in his graciousness says, Marcia, you have to rebuke that thought against the Lord. You have to rebuke that thought. You have to bring it captive to the submission of the Lord. Okay. So, Father, I'm praying for every beloved saint that's struggling, whether it be with their bills, their health, their children, their spouses leaving them, cheating on them. Father, I'm lifting up every beloved saint, whether it be two saints that engaged in this, the one have repented and the one haven't. I'm praying for them, Father, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, we need you. We need you in every area of our lives. Yes, Father, in the name of Jesus. And now, Lord, we know you hear us when we cry, when we pray, when we make requests, supplication. We are standing in the gap for our older children, even our young children, our grandchildren, their parents, their other grandparents. We're standing in the gap for the salvation of many. Amen. How about our enemies? Father, you said to pray for our enemies, that their eyes would be open. Yes, Lord Jesus. And we're asking this, Father, we're asking all these wonderful things in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. And we thank you, we praise you, because we know for you to hear us is for you to answer us. We know you can, we know you will, and we know it's already done. You said, believe that we receive when we ask. Amen. So I thank you, Father. I thank you so much for every beloved saint that have sowed into my life, no matter how small, how big. I thank you all, beloved saints. I thank you. I thank you for those who plan to bless me. Thank you. And I especially thank you for those who, Lord, who are helping me to be a blessing to the children and some of these single moms and a couple of single dads out here. Thank you, beloved saints. When you give to me, you best believe you are giving to the Lord. Amen. And I have not forgotten to put up on my community post the pictures of what I just did with the single moms and the children this past Sunday. I was getting to it, you all. So I just thank you, Heavenly Father, for this time to break bread, the living word. This is not no water. This is not no milk. This is going to be meat. And that's why a lot of folks is malnutrition, because they just want water and milk. And they have not become mature sons. And son is not masculine. It means mature servants and children of the Most High Yahweh. Okay? Okay. Amen. Hallelujah. So get out your Bibles. Turn to Isaiah chapter 55, verse 1. Ho. All in caps. Every is in caps. Ho, H-O. Ho, every, all caps. One that thirsts. See, this is where you need to find out if you actually are thirsting and hungering for righteousness. Because Jesus did say in the Beatitudes, blessed is he that thirsts and hunger after righteousness, they shall be filled. So this is why we got a lot of carnal, lukewarm, Lord, Lord community Christians. They don't thirst after the holy things of the Lord. And the holiest of the holiest is the Lord's word and his presence, his holy blood and his holy name and his Holy Ghost. Ho, everyone that thirsts, come ye to the waters. And he that hath no money, come you, buy and eat. You come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. So you say, what is that talking about, Sister Marcia? I was going to tell you. The Lord in this last hour is saying, if you don't let him purify you and wash you with his word, you know how when Peter said, don't just wash my feet. Sometimes he did get ahead of himself. He did, you all. He meant well, but he was sincerely wrong. The Lord said, if I don't clean you, if I don't wash your feet, you can have no part in me. So this is why you lukewarm carnal Christians, you got no part in Christ right now. But that is subject to change if you come. You hear me? And you drink in these living waters of the holy word of the Almighty Yahweh. He said, come. And you wonder why you haven't received any living waters. Because your pastors are pussing with lust, lasciviousness, sins, gross sins. The biggest one is the God of Mammon. They is 501c3s. You guys can stand there if you want to. It's your choice. But if I was you all, I would get the getting while the getting is good. Because any pastor that's not telling you we need to come to the altar on a Sunday basis, you ought to have an altar at home. But at least if you had one at the church, the brick and mortar, because we is the church, at least you could get right. Okay, so that's Isaiah 51, verse 1. So now, that scripture Thank you, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, oh, see what fasting will do. If you go in the middle of your Bible at the bottom or on the side, mine is in the middle. I'm going to pick up my Bible so I can show you. This is how you do line upon line, precept upon precept, here a little, there a little, and go from faith to faith and glory to glory. You're not going to do that outside of the word and applying the word. Jesus said, don't be ye hearers only of my word, but doers, for it will be the doer that will be justified. So what you do, I read Isaiah 50 verse 50, blah, 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 Isaiah chapter 55 verse 1. And I said, let me look that up. And it led me to John after Luke, John chapter 4 verse 14. So turn in your Bible to John chapter 4 verse 14. But, and anytime the Lord put the buts in the way, you better listen very, very intently, very, very intently, because that's what the word Selah means. Selah means to really chew on it, swallow it, bring it back up, the word of God. I mean, really meditate on it, because he's not playing with any of his word. But this right here, this is very, very, very serious, because if you're not drinking living waters, you got to ask yourself what you've been drinking. I tell you, doctrines of demons. Live your best life now. God wants you happy, healthy, and wealthy. It's okay to spend some time. You can twerk, smoke your weed, make up your drink mixtures, go out and party. Okay. John, let me turn to it in my Bible too. I got it written out. Because see, that's what will help you to memorize the word of the Lord, writing out these scriptures. Mm-hmm. Yes, it will. Okay. Here we go. Oh, I had it right here. Okay. John chapter 4, verse 14. But whosoever drinketh of the waters that I shall give him shall never thirst, but the waters that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. So if you is carnal and lukewarm and so proud to say we is all sinners, use a lie. I'm not no sinner. I'm the righteous. I'm a beloved saint. I'm a son. I'm a child of the Lord. I am a priest unto the Lord. No, I'm not no sinner. I don't practice sinning. So don't include me in that mess. Now, thank you, Holy Spirit. The reason why you all like saying you sinners, he told me, because you like sinning. And I'm going to move on, because we don't got time for that foolishness. All right. So the reason why most folks don't have a springing up into eternal life is because they don't read the word of the Lord. And better yet, the word, if they do read it, they're not walking the walk. They just talking the talk. So you keep playing church instead of being a house of the Lord, the temple of the Lord. Let's go on, because we don't have time for foolishness. Now, that led me to Matthew chapter 13, verse 44. Let's go on over here. Let's go on over here. See, I was called to get you ready, and I've been on my post. I've been on my post. Yes, Lord, and I thank you, Jesus. I'm boasting in the Lord, because I could be somewhere depressed. I could be somewhere having a pity party, but I said, no, Jesus, this is not the time to be depressed, saints. You got to shake that demon off of you by going up in a praise or a worship or down on your knees or open up the word of God, the Almighty Yahweh. You better do it. He's not coming for a depressed bride, honey. What bride is depressed and she getting ready to get married? You all, that don't make no sense. Okay, Matthew chapter 13, verse 44. Yeah, it's time to get right. Yep. Again, look at this. And this is in red, you all. You Christians say you love Jesus. Well, I'm finna tell you what Jesus is saying to you and to me. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like unto treasure hid in a field, that which when a man has found, he hideth. And for the joy thereof, going and selling all that he hath, and buying the field. I'll read that again. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like unto treasure hid in a field. Excuse me, picture in your mind a field and finding treasure down in the ground. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Do you guys know what we made of? Dirt. We's made of dirt. And can the Lord find himself in your dirt? I hope so. Okay. Like unto treasure hid in a field, the which when a man has found, he hideth, and for the joy thereof goeth and selleth all that he hath and buyeth that field. And you know he did that on Calvary, right? Did y'all know that he talking about his crucifixion, his sacrifice? And this is why when you stay in sin, you are literally trampling over the holy blood of the Holy Son of God. If I was you all, I would hurry up and get some fear, a whole lot of it, of the Lord. And when I say fear, I mean, be very afraid. Be very afraid because he's holy. And he's going to throw all those who don't fear him, but they fear their boss. They fear their husband. They fear doctors. They fear They fear their pastors, their apostles, bishops, and preachers and teachers and evangelists. But they don't fear the Almighty Yahweh. You got to be out your mind. That's why the Lord said the beginning of wisdom is the fear of the Lord. Depart, you once saved, always saved. Depart. If you depart from somebody or someplace, you leave it. Depart from sin and iniquity. And iniquity is practicing sin and don't even care, not even convicted. Don't fear God, not a little bit, not none. So, it say he buyeth that field. So if you keep on reading it, you'll come into more examples of what the kingdom of the Lord is like. So you do that for yourself. I'm gonna go on. All right, let's turn to Revelation Chapter 3, verse 18. Let's go on over here. A book that most pastors won't even crack open. Ain't never one time taught about it. And you think they going up in our pot, so okay, you wait right there with them. Chapter 3, this is in red again. Pretty much the whole book of Revelation is in red. Chapter 3, verse 18. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep-er. I counsel thee, this is Jesus talking to you and talking to me. I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire. Let me get that picture out that the Lord gave this young man, Judah. And here I thought he was doing wrong colors. I was talking about Judah, the globe is blue and brown. The Lord said, I told him to color it that way. Didn't I tell you all the Lord is coming for his gold and his silver? See, this is what you get when you raise your children up to fear the Lord. I said, Jesus is coming for his, the boy used a gold pencil and a silver pencil. This is the Holy Spirit right here. The cross that's empty, praise God, Brother Anthony, because he, Brother Anthony, and I don't blame him. He don't like when folks be wearing a cross with Jesus on it. It's an abomination. It's a mockery. He drew a cross with blood dripping from it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Do you know this is complete salvation, sanctification, and holiness and righteousness in the Lord by way of the power of the Holy Ghost called grace? Grace is not just time. Grace is the anointed power of the Holy Spirit to say no to fornicating, no to masturbating, no to drugs, no to twerking, no to lying, no to gossiping, and all other sin. Okay, let's get on back to it. Because see, if you won't say yes to Jesus, you gonna say yes to this. You is getting ready to see the Antichrist. You is getting ready to see horrors that the world has never seen. Jesus said there ain't never been a time like it, nor will there ever be. Okay, so verse 18 is got three sixes in it. I counsel you to buy of me gold tried in the fire. And this is the fires of trials and tribulations in our life. See, I can take my time. I'm gonna take my time. You either gonna be purified by the Holy Spirit's fire, or you can say, hello, hello, fire. Because this gonna be a lot of this during the tribulation, whole lot. It done already started. We are either gonna let the Lord purify our hearts, our minds, our souls, even our spirits, or we gonna go through, as Fig Tree Ministry say, the classroom of tribulation. The choice is yours, always. So now Jesus say to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich. And see, you got your pastors telling you to network, get more money so you can give it to him. But he's not telling you to be rich in the spirit, praying, fasting in the word, and good works out there to children and to folks who need it. He said, tell it. When I went out there to give them single mothers that dishwashing detergent, dishwashing detergent for the dishes and a fabric softener, there was a Puerto Rican mama. I'm going to meet her because I'm going to take her some more stuff. She said, told her son, go tell the lady, God be with her. God be with you. And he came out on his bike and he said, my mom said, God be with you, sister. God be with you. And I said, see, she's raising her children to know the Lord. Everybody in projects ain't ghetto. I said, everyone living in the projects and ghetto. And that's really not the projects. Let me correct myself. People try to lump it with the projects, but it's not. And I'm not going to say what's the name of it. I'm not going to do that. No. What it is our communities. Okay. So now he said, to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich and white remnant. Do you know, this is twofold. Thank you, Holy Spirit. If we don't get right and purify right now, we're not going to have a white robe. We're not going to have that white robe. But now if we don't get right and we left behind, we're going to still have to go through that fire. That's right. All right. That you may be rich and white remnant, that thou mayest be clothed. Then he said, read it again. Take your time, Marcia. I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, and white remnant, that thou mayest be clothed, comma, and that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear. Christians, you're going to be naked going to church every Sunday. And your pastor's going to be naked right with you. Mm-hmm. Look at this. These vowels. And that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear. And anoint thine eyes with eye slave, that thou mayest see. Did you all hear that? So you tell me, I want you to tell me this, because you can't, how I can live and start sin and gonna go up and no harpazo. Ain't no way. It's not gonna happen. So let's go on. All right. Read verses 19, 20, 21, and 22. Okay, Lord, let's go. This is still Jesus talking to you Christians who say you love him. Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandments. He even said, keep thyself in the love of the Lord, the love of the Lord. How you do that? Love to the Lord is called, it's spelled O-B-E-Y, obeying him. The highest form of worship is obedience and the fear of the Lord. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. See, I learned the fear of the Lord is worship from Brother Wally. You need to go on over there because he has a deeper meaning of Jesus than anybody I know. And I don't care who get jealous, because I know you do. I know you don't like when I say that, but I'm praying for you, brother and sister. I'm praying for you. You will get, that's why it's called Revelations of Jesus. So, you all, we need to fear the Lord. We need to fear the Lord, and we need to show and prove to him that we fear him. We don't want to obey him out of fear. We want to obey him out of love. But we want to fear him and stay away from sin and iniquity and running them big lips or thin lips. Either or. They big because they always gossiping. So I don't care if your lips is paper thin, like my mama's used to be. She was like Lucille Ball. Do you hear me? My mother had, I can't believe that. My mama, I sure didn't get my lips from her. So anyway, I'm talking about big and gossiping, slandering. Yeah. I had a sister had the nerve to tell me one Sunday that she loved me more. I said, Lord, Christian is the most lying folks I've ever seen in my life. The child hate me so bad, but that's okay because I love her and that's what matters. See, God gonna look at what's down in me towards her. Not only is she sharp, she beautiful. But unfortunately, I'd rather see a beautiful soul and a beautiful heart and spirit than beauty on the outside. And the Lord is that way too. Okay. Verse 19. As many as I love. See why he told me to read. See how he didn't let me get this. You see this. Here you go. Once saved, always saved. Lukewarm, carnal Christians. This Jesus. As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Be zealous, therefore, you lukewarm, you carnal, and repent. Behold, I stand at the door. You know he's at the door. So you all ignore what Jesus, the Holy Son of the Almighty Heavenly Father, ignore him if you want to. Play with Jesus if you want to. He say, I stand at the door and knock. If any person, but it say man, which means mankind, human being. If any person hear my voice and open the door, what door? The door of our hearts. I will come into him and will sup with him and he with me. That's called RELATIONSHIP, relationship with the Lord. And when we have a relationship with Jesus by way of the Holy Spirit, we have fellowship with the Father. Mm-hmm. Yes. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Yes. Oh, this fasting is awesome because it's the Lord. When it says they that worship the Lord, here you go, you choir in the choir and the praise team folk, Christians. They that worship the Lord must worship him in spirit and in truth. You cannot worship the Lord unless you are born again of the Spirit and you know the truth, which is his word, which is him. They that worship the Lord must be born again of the Spirit in their spirit and in truth, his word, which is him, Jesus, God in flesh. So keep singing in vain. Okay. Let's see here. To him that cometh. See, this is who he's coming for. This trip on out, this catching away, he coming for the overcomers. He coming for his bride without spot or wrinkle, which is corresponding when it say spot and wrinkles, talking about sin and iniquity. When it say laying aside the sins and the weights that so easily beset us from the Lord, he said, lay them aside, get rid of them, and pray that you be counted worthy. It say pray, while y'all not praying, that you be counted worthy to escape all that's coming upon the face of the earth. Okay, 21. To him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame. You see that? That's why we can overcome. Greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world, the spirit of the world, Satan, and his demonic hosts and his foot soldiers. We are the greater ones in the earth because the greater one lives in us. So I don't know how you can be once saved, always saved, sinning up a storm. Lifestyle of lasciviousness and debauchery and lust, divers lust. You got folks that swing to the vagina, to the penis. I said it. Swinging to the male and to the female. Go to church every Sunday. Ain't no way. That is unclean spirits. And I'm praying for everyone. Oh, Lord. Do you know it says those who are of that homosexuality and bisexuality are going to burn in the lake of fire of brimstone? Ain't nobody. Ain't no feeling. Ain't no unforgiveness. Sisters who done turned gay. I wouldn't care what man hurt your soul, your heart, your body. Baby, it's not worth it. And you brothers who have been hurt by fathers, abusive fathers, even sisters, abusive mothers, abusive caregivers. Because a lot of people ended up going in that lifestyle because of abuse and hurt and rejection. You go look at my first video. I said it. Don't no baby wake up and don't no person wake up and say, oh, I think I'm going to be gay. I think I'm going to be an alcoholic. I think I'm going to be a pedophiler, because God loves them too. All they need to do is repent and come clean. No, it's not. It's an egregious sin. But now there's no sin that can't be repented of, but blasphemous of the Holy Spirit, being blasphemy of the Holy Spirit and taking one's own life. Yes, I got to say it. I'm not going to be a coward for nobody. So you all, my Lord, we have no business being under the yoke of fear and sin. Do you know the first thing Jesus said is going to the lake of fire, burning with brimstone, is the fearful and all liars? And then abominations, the abominable. Yep. Yes. Yep. Okay. I'm going to get that scripture. Okay. So it say, to him that overcometh, will I grant to sit, overcome what? Sin. You once saved, always saved. Grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne. 22. He that has an ear. See, this is not for everybody that come here. I know you're coming here. You is a troll. You are one who bite and devours. You are the lukewarm. You are the carnal. You are the one saved, always saved. You are the religious without a relationship with Jesus. That's what religious is. They don't know Jesus. You don't know the Lord, and he don't know you, and he's going to tell you, depart from me. I never knew you, you workers of iniquity. Why would Jesus say workers of iniquity, and you can once saved, always saved, and you can just sin up a storm? A lifestyle of it. Ain't no way. Okay, verse 22. And he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit, capital S, saith unto the churches. The churches. We are the church. You understand? We are. So what is the opposite if you don't have an ear? You're deaf, dumb, and blind. And when you choose to be blind, well, now, the Bible said blind guides, the blind leading the blind, and they both fall into a ditch. Translation, a pit that's in hell and fire. So keep on following your blind pastors, your bishops, your apostles, your preachers, your teachers, your evangelists. You're both going to hell together. See, this is why Peter or Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. Soon as somebody go to the left and they not stand with Jesus on the path that leads to the path of righteousness that leads to eternal life, that's when you ought to say, well, like that man that was at the piano in the color purple, grabbed his hat, put it on, grabbed his briefcase and said, well, and closed his piano and said, well, time to go. You ought to be dedicated and committed to Jesus like you are your apostle, your bishop, your pastor, your preacher, your teacher. No, see, that's idolatry. Thank Holy Spirit. I see, this makes me want to fast more. You all, I say you all are worshiping flesh and blood. You know, the Lord hates that. That's called idolatry. Okay. Am I finished, Lord? Show is 1 hour, 18 minutes, and 15 seconds and counting. So you all, I's done. I done dropped the hot word in the spirit of Jesus Christ. I have such peace. I have warned. I have blown the trumpet. I've been an oracle for the Almighty, living Almighty Yahweh. I's not worried about nothing but keeping myself under. See that? I got enough with me. And that's why a lot of pastors and preachers, they in a lot of trouble because they didn't keep themselves under and humble. No accountability out here. No fear of the Lord in these brick and mortars. Come out wherever you are and run as fast as you can like the gingerbread man. Run now. Because the wrath is coming on in. Sudden destruction any moment now. And do I pray he come by this month? Oh, yes, I do. But now I got enough sense and love and compassion and patience. He said, wait patiently for your lover, the lover of my soul, Jesus. Wait patiently for the Lord. Because I want as many as can could come on in. But now, I would love for him to come on this month. Yes, I would. But now we is going to occupy and go about doing good, keep working on our hearts, our character, our soul, even our personality, to become more like Jesus. Amen. I want to talk about Jesus. Y'all look for that video. Little girl says she want to talk about Jesus. Wow. No wonder the Lord said, come like a child. And no wonder he say, for if you don't come like a child, you will not enter into the kingdom of God, because such is the kingdom of God. Because children are pliable. They're easy. Yep. Yes. When they wrong, they say, Mama, I'm sorry. Daddy, you forgive me, Daddy. So I done what I was supposed to do. I love you all, even you trolls and you mockers and you scoffers. Oh, I do. Don't like you, sure don't trust you, but I love you. And I'm praying for you all to get the fear of the Lord, depart from sin and iniquity, and do good. God bless you all. I'll be back. Please keep me lifted up, saints. I love you all. Bye-bye.